Born into a family devoted to public service, Eunice Kennedy would herself answer that call closest to home. Young Eunice took her abilities, combined with her deep religious beliefs, and went in search of answers. That lifelong search has taken her to places where few were willing to venture. It was social reform that sparked something profound within Eunice. Her passion and her early work led her to those who were neglected or marginalized in society. In 1953, Eunice married Sergeant Shriver, who shared her passion. The two would work side by side in search of a new focus for the Joseph P. Kennedy Jr. Foundation.
And I hope that in the 1960s, these years will be known as years in which the United States took the leadership in the great effort to make it possible to discover what we can do to make these boys and girls' life more hopeful and fruitful.
In 1962, with her brother leading the nation, Eunice wrote an article for the Saturday Evening Post. Here she openly shared what had been hidden in misplaced shame in society to make one of the most significant contributions to our nation's awareness to the need of research of mental retardation. In personal and universal terms, it would tell thousands of families affected by intellectual disability that they were not alone and that above all, there was hope. But knowing that words alone would not change long-held attitudes about intellectual disability, Eunice would apply the love of sports embraced by her family to bring life to her vision at another level. With the loving support of her family, she would begin her life's work literally in her backyard. Affectionately dubbed Camp Shriver, Eunice didn't expect miracles at her camp, but miracles happened. Camp Shriver was a place where people with intellectual disability were not only encouraged, but more importantly, challenged in what was the arena where the groundwork for her great gift to the world was born. And then in 1968, Special Olympics would begin with the voice that would extend one of humanity's most noble traditions to those perhaps disabled, but equally deserving.
In ancient Rome, the gladiators went into the arena with these words on their lips. Let me win, but if I cannot win, let me be brave in the attempt.
The stands of Soldier Field may not have been filled that first year, but every athlete, official, coach, and volunteer had been profoundly touched. 40 years later, empty fields of dreams now glow with dazzling dreams fulfilled. And Special Olympics flourishes as one of the most compelling, most widely applauded, and most widely supported movements in global history. Today, Special Olympics has expanded into the farthest corners of the globe and offers over 2 million athletes in 169 countries an opportunity to enjoy the year-round benefits of sports training and competition through Special Olympics.
You send a message to every village, every city, every nation. A message of hope, a message of victory. The right to play on any playing field, you have earned it. The right to study in any school, you have earned it. The right to hold a job, you have earned it.
In support of this worldwide movement, Eunice has gained the attention of many of the great leaders, athletes, entertainers, celebrities of our era who recognize that in giving of their time to help others, it has more often they themselves who reap the greatest rewards. Eunice has also established and supported many significant programs that contribute to the well-being of people with intellectual disability, like Community of Caring and Best Buddies, while continuing her efforts to lead Special Olympics to new heights. Her work has had dramatic effect in the transformation of attitudes and the removal of stereotypical negativity around the world while improving health care to thousands of people and providing ongoing encouragement and hope to families who face the daily challenges of raising children with intellectual disability. And to all who are involved in Special Olympics, the words of Eunice come to life, knowing that as we hope in the best of them, hope is reborn in us. It is Eunice Kennedy Shriver who has earned the place among those who exemplify the power of one person and one voice to make a difference.
If you seek joy, come see the Special Olympians. If you seek peace and understanding, come see the athletes of Special Olympics. And if you seek courage or skill or strength, you come and see the athletes of Special Olympics. You are an example for the whole world.
Founder of Special Olympics and international ambassador of love, dignity, and hope, Eunice Kennedy Shriver, a voice of change.